we call it video sales presenters now. So more video sales presenters, people with energy and personalities that they can just, you know, show up in someone's inbox and, you know, first thing in the morning and just kind of make their day with just their infectiousness and their personality and their vibrance.
Hey, what's up, everyone? This is Jeremy, founder of QuickMail.io.
Hey, and this is Jack from emailsthatsell.com. Today,
interview.
Hey, what's up? We're going to pick up the conversation with Trevor, and he's going to continue to school us on his secrets to outbound success. With that, let's jump right back into the conversation. Enjoy.
I really want to hear how you use video to generate leads for your design company.
Video is something we started to tinker with. And like, as I'm sure you can see the pattern here, we're always testing, experimenting, and just seeing what works. And
learning.
I forget how we stumbled upon the solution. It was called Loom. I'm not sure if you heard of it.
Sure, it's awesome.
Loom's a tool that allows you to kind of simply and easily record and send like video messages. It's automatically, there's a browser extension. You hit record. You can record yourself saying a message. It's not a high production thing by any means. You can say, say whatever you want, and you can send it pretty simply in an email. So I forget, the first time I used it was I had a demo that was scheduled with someone and she didn't make it. And I just thought, you know what? I'm just going to record this demo. I'm just going to record myself just doing this demo and basically giving my sales pitch and sending it over. And it worked really well. Actually, the response was really well. And it was, you know, a 10, probably a 12 minute long video. And I could see that she watched the whole thing. And I thought, okay, maybe there's something here to that. Instead of, in some cases, waiting until people came to us, engaged us, you know, booked the demo, maybe I'll just bring the demo to them. Now, naturally, you know, I didn't think at first that I could get away with sending a 15 minute video to people just cold out of the blue. But I'm telling you, we tried it and the response rates and the open rates and the view rates, the view to completion rates was remarkable, that people actually, when it was created, A, targeted specific to them, and B, delivered in a way that kind of caught their attention, you know, that got them to open it and then got them to progressively watch each step in the process. I was very surprised to see that we actually could keep people engaged for a fair amount of time by sending them a video just directly in email. So that was, we did it the one time, it worked really well. And I said, all right, let's try this out. And so I went back to our list of contacts that were kind of warm, people that already heard from us before. And I said, all right, let's do 10 of these. Let's do 15 of these and send it out and see what happens. Again, response rates were starting to pile up significantly. I was very, very surprised by that. And so that's when we took a step back and we said, all right, there's something here. This might be the next step in our evolution. You know, how do we scale this? How do we create a process around this, which was most important? And so that's what we've been kind of tinkering with and working on for the last couple of weeks, about a month or month ago. What really kicked all this off was I had a week, about 5 weeks ago, where I sent out 100 of these videos. And normally a good week for us is because of how specific we are, we sign a new client every week. And I sent out 100 of these, and the following week we signed 5 clients that week. I knew there was something there, something to that. And so we just said, okay.
Video definitely builds trust. I'm curious, do you actually customize the video itself? And in your email, what's the ratio video versus text? Like, do you just send just the video? Obviously, there is some text with it. Like, here's the video. Or do you actually introduce and then the video? Or
do you have a screenshot?
Yeah. And also, I'm building an encyclopedia of cool emails. So, you know, if you're happy and comfortable sharing it, then, you know, I'll be happy to receive it as well.
Yeah, actually, of course, we've been kind of working on in the back, probably some resources. So I can probably ship something over to you. Just
love that.
The last year of trials and testing and what's happened in the lab here, I'll send that over to you. It's essentially, we also have one of our resources we built out called the Encyclopedia of Marketing Stuff. And that's a pretty fun, kind of cool ebook. I'll ship that over to you.
Great.
But to answer your question, yeah, so the approach for the video messages, like everything else, just something we've been kind of tinkering and experimenting. So the first ones, the 100 that I sent out, you might see this pattern here that I'm like, when I obsess over something, I don't mind spending time over it. The 100, each of them, I kid you not, were 15 minute long demos that I recorded myself, all 100 in about a week time.
One at a time.
But were they exactly the same, or do you actually just change the name, or do you actually adapt it to what you think the company will need, or what's the catch here?
Each one was 100% custom to that company, every single one.
Got it.
Well, the framework, the layout. So I would start in a video by brief introduction to the solution, try to touch on the pain points right away. Like, here's some of the pain points, introduce the solution, and then jump right into a demo.
And you were browsing their website at the same time. Is that what made it specially for them? Or were you just presenting a sales pitch, like a deck?
So the email they would receive from us is just a quick little one-liner, just something like, hey, just came across XYZ website. We work with a bunch of companies in this space. You know, I created this video for you. And usually I found I could just leave it at that. As soon as you can just say, created this video for you. What they see below that is a screenshot of their website. And it's actually a GIF. It's a GIF of me browsing their website and me talking right on the video. So it doesn't really matter what I'm going to say in the beginning of that email. It's going to capture their attention, especially right now. It's such a new approach.
That's right.
That, I imagine this will be the standard probably in a couple of years, but right now
it would fade out.
It's so unique that people, they see it for the first time, they've got to watch it, right? And so the process, the approach is to just have these incremental steps where I'm just trying to get them to take the next action. The first action is watch the video. Once I go from the email into the video,
So I click your video, I take your first step. It takes me to a landing page.
Yep. Takes over to a landing page where your custom video is there. And again, so you're looking at now, is this a screenshot of your website? It's me talking. And I just kind of go right into some of the pain points. Again, being able to address marketing managers, starting with, hey, Trevor from Dark Roast here. We work with a lot of marketing managers in this space. Now, I'm not sure what you're doing for graphic design at the moment, but my guess is it's probably not as efficient or as seamless as you'd like it to be. And there's probably some roadblocks in the way, whether you got to, book a meeting or find the budget or just wait until someone's available. And so I just thought, you might be interested in seeing this new solution that a lot of marketing managers and high performing marketers are switching over to, called graphic design on demand. I kind of fleshed that out a little bit more, but then I would go, probably spend a little more time on the pain points. Then I'd go right into the solution, talking about what it is that we provide. Now, we provide you your own go-to graphic designer that's always available that you can access anytime. You never have to worry about the cost or finding the budget. And we also have the simple, seamless, easy way for you to start and manage projects in minutes without meetings. And so, especially with pandemic going on, I've kind of touched on some of the pain points there in terms of how people are adapting and changing right now. With everything going on in the world, budgets are getting tighter. People are finding it hard to kind of work remotely. And so I just thought you might want to see this solution that's going to allow you to work from anywhere on a tight budget. So that would go into that. That'd be the solution. And then I just jump right into a demo by saying something like, it's one thing for me to try to tell you about it, but I understand how marketers think. You want to actually see it and be able to internalize how it's going to work for yourself. And if you stick with me for 3 more minutes, I'll show you exactly how it works. And if you stick with me to the end, I promise it'll be worth it, because you're going to see something that you've never seen before that could change the way you work. And there's a bunch of free stuff for you at the end. So I promise it's going to be worth it. Stick with me to the end. And so go through the demo, play the demo. At the end of it, that's our call to action, which is, now that you've seen this, we'd love to create something for you for free. It's one thing to see how it works, but we want for you to be able to experience it for yourself. So just let us know what you can create for you for free. That's the language that we started to use, as opposed to like start a free trial. It's just, what can we do for you for free? And so that was kind of that, those having those like segues, each one, just getting them to go to the next step is what we found allows people, keeps them engaged for 10, 15 minutes in this cold video that we're sending out. That was the first approach. And now we're getting to where we're splitting that up. The intro is completely custom and unique, and then the demo is something that's pre-recorded just to save us some time so that we can scale that up a little bit more.
I knew it was a great idea to have you on the show, Trevor. That was freaking brilliant. We have to ask you for some of the books and podcasts and resources that make you such a sharp marketer at the end of the podcast. But that's brilliant, man. And I understand, we could get very deep into how you follow up with people that view but do not reply, but with an email, a phone call, or whatnot. But if there isn't anything like really noteworthy there, we can transition to some of your questions about scaling and automating some of this process. I think we may have a good brainstorm session if we've got, another 10 minutes. Does that sound fair, guys?
Yeah, that works.
Sure.
All right, man. So scaling, let's talk about it.
Yeah. So I'll tell you kind of where we're at in terms of our plans to scale. And I'd love to get some of your thoughts as to what's the best approach. So having identified this new solution that just kind of spiked even more success, like we were growing, everything was going well for us. We tried this new thing, it just spiked like a lightning rod, like instantly as soon as we tried it out, very, very successful. And so now we're saying, okay, that's going to be our approach. And so let's try to build and scale around this. And so right away, actually a couple weeks ago, we ended up hiring someone that's going to kind of take over some of this process. And so what we're doing right now is trying to figure out the mechanism, the technical part of scaling this, you know, how to actually deliver the video, how to record them is pretty straightforward. But we're trying to figure out the proper messaging. How do we segment this? How do we have it kind of halfway personalized, but also having pre-recorded demo without losing them in between, right? It's that transition from here's this part's personalized. Now we're telling them that we're going to this pre-recorded demo. So that's kind of the messaging there. How we approach that, that's the challenge that we're kind of having right now. And I don't know, you know, as I mentioned, you mentioned we could talk for another hour on exactly the approach here. I don't know if you got enough of an understanding of how what we're trying to accomplish, but maybe you guys have some thoughts on how we can kind of transition or use that messaging so we can scale this a little bit better.
I was thinking that one of the things you could potentially do is still make it like personalized in a sense of finding customer you already worked with and told them the results you achieved with those ones. So the automated generic video will actually be a teardown of what you actually did for someone else that is exactly like them. So, you know, you come in with the introduction, super personalized, and you say, and by the way, let me show you what we did with a client that is exactly like you. And then boom, you can effectively put this video that is, you know, kind of generic. And that way you don't lose them into like something like too fluffy, not very concrete and so on. So that would be my thought process initially.
And so, yeah, you're right, have pre-recorded videos, but in a way have like a series of pre-recorded videos, like specific
right.
to an industry, right? So
it's
pre-recorded, but it's customized in a way or specific to them in a way.
That's
yeah,
exactly
that makes
right.
sense. I like that.
Okay, so now you'll hear my
side. So he's the hacker, Jack.
Yeah, yeah. So, or anti-hacker once you hear this, but like from what I understand, the question is how do we ramp things up? How do we put some automation there so that we can get some results coming in even faster? Well, Jeremy told me a story a couple of years back about a hackathon for, you know, $1 million prize. Whoever could crack the Google CAPTCHA challenge would get $1 million. And the most brilliant programmers went to work on this thing and they like threw software and automation at the problem. But then along comes this like simple team who says, yeah. You want to finish it?
No. It's just that funny thing is that the CAPTCHA keeps on changing. So, you know, it's like a mouse and cat. It never ends. So, yeah. So that was the stage. Yeah.
So anyway, here comes this team who was like, screw automation. I'm just going to have a human being, just more of them, go ahead and fill all these CAPTCHAs. And they won the prize because they had a system in place that solved it. And in your case, here you are with a very unique position. And forgive me if I'm sounding like a drill sergeant here, but you've got something that works. Don't muck it up by scaling and worrying about automation. Perhaps all you have to do is give the script to a couple more people and say, look, we got about 5K kind of prospects out there. Your job every day will be to repeat what I've done. It works at this rate. And by now, you know how much money it makes you guys. So just plug in how much it would cost to have two or three people become you. And then you know it's already going to work. Like you've scaled, right?
That's obviously an approach that I think makes perfect sense given this, because you're right. Maybe we're trying to solve find a solution to this problem that doesn't exist. You can't scale or automate this very manual process. And so you're right.
The reason it works is because it's manual, right?
Yeah.
So
it's the same story as your postcard, you know, if you think about it. You didn't actually write them all, you know, by hand.
Yeah, exactly.
The other approach that you can consider or think of is doing a two-layer video. That's something that Intercom is using. And you can see, you can go to coldoutreachtemplates.com and you can see the template of Intercom. And basically, this is also an animated GIF that will then send you to a video. And that video has two things. You have a woman speaking. Actually, she's boring as hell, so don't go that road. But on the side, there is a video on top of it that is scrolling the website of that person. So in a sense, you just basically put one video on top of the other one and you can still see both, right? If that makes sense. And so that's another way of doing it. And then you can use what Jack is saying, just get someone to actually record someone scrolling the website of someone or going to certain position, you know, at certain keyframe or a certain time. And that way you can effectively have your beautiful voice with your energy, your passion at the same time someone seeing is their own website and where the things you're saying is going to be impacted.
you got to find that balance of like, you know, creating some efficiencies and doing things like that, but also not creating more and more work, right? If we're getting to editing every video, then that's going to limit what we can actually, you know, put out and things like that. And in fact,
absolutely. But you do have some scripts now with pretty much every video software, so it's pretty easy to actually, you know, plug things automatically.
So the tool that we just invested in is called Vidyard. Vidyard is, this is what's their wheelhouse, is what they do. And so they've got a lot of really great tools internally and functions that allow us to automate some of this to a degree. But our approach and our thoughts were, in many cases, it was the content, the messaging, the personality on camera. So in fact, I'm not going to be doing these videos myself much longer. We just hired a girl, her name's Ebony. She is phenomenal. She's bursting with energy and she's vibrant. Nice. She was a model, an actress. So that's the approach that we're getting at. So, you know, A, the videos themselves were already pretty engaging because it was new and unique. And because the solution we were showing in the video was in itself, again, unique and worth sticking around for. And now we're layering on this kind of entertainment value to it as well that we think is going to kick that into overdrive. So that's what Ebony is going to help us with. And then hopefully maybe she can be the one that then build the team around her and find more, you know, we call it video sales presenters now. So more video sales presenters, people with energy and personalities funny. That they can just, you know, show up in someone's inbox and, you know, first thing in the morning and just kind of make their day with just their infectiousness and their personality and their vibrance.
It's a new job of 2020, you know, video sales presenter now.
Okay, so let's say Ebony is cranking out these videos and following the protocol here. Is, you know, life peachy? Is there anything else that is holding you back from scaling? Because I want to make sure I answer that question without giving like a bit of a cop-out answer, you know, where it's just like, don't automate. You know, I think, does that solve it? Does it really help?
For the most part, yeah. I feel like it's the perfect solution, I think, for what we are and what we're trying to be right now. You know, it's saying that we're only going to do outbound forever. It's just going to, I don't know if that's actually going to work for us. So the other challenge for us with scaling is how do we then have any type of inbound approach? How do we have, you know, people coming to us and still maintaining that, you know, very specific clientele, that very, very specific client avatar with the people that we're going to work with, without having 100 people, you know, signing up for free trials and having to turn most of them away. So that's, I think, going to be our next challenge in terms of scale is.
Yeah. You need a qualifier. Yeah. So on the, hey, grab a free thing, make them jump through quite a few hoops if they're going to get a free thing for you. And one of those hoops is they have to work at the right kind of company and have the right kind of job title or else. And in fact, here's what's kind of the nice thing that I want to say double-edged sword, but it's the opposite of that. The double bonus is when you call out, this is only for marketing managers at companies like this, it actually gets rid of the tire kickers. And then the marketing manager says, wait a minute, this is different from all the other stuff I've seen, you know, that pulls them into your universe harder. So yeah, so adding some layers to filter out everyone you don't want to work with. And by the way, like you're totally allowed to say, we give marketing managers a free go at this, but if you're everyone else, we're not for you. And I would hold true to that because that's part of your brand, right?
Yeah. Now, how far do you think we can take that exclusivity, exclusive nature? Like, do we get to the point where like everything is private and secretive? Like, do you think we can get to that? And if it's effective to get to that point, or do we find like some thin lines and balance there?
What do you mean secretive?
Yeah.
We had thought about the idea of just having like our website is just like black with like a login. And like you, if you want to know what's going on behind here, you've got to either be referred to it or you've got to be.
If you want to win with inbound, you're going to lose with that approach. Fair enough.
I know. Yeah. So that again, that goes back to the struggles of what we're trying to accomplish.
The other thing is that you seem to be pretty good, you know, in personalization and reaching out to strangers. How about, you know, reaching out to your existing clients again? Because it's likely that they don't have like one single need, but they may have it like next year again, or maybe in 2 years' time. So there is potential value, and stop me if I'm wrong, but there is potential value in re-engaging with your existing prospect.
I just want to clarify, you said clients or?
Yeah, past clients. Sorry, my bad. Re-engaging with past clients.
Mm.
Like past clients, like before we switched over to this business model, the on-demand.
Or people who stopped working with you at some point, you know, maybe 2 years down the line, then they have needs again coming up and just wanted to re-engage with you. We've done a great job together. Just wanted to let you know that we're also covering X and B, or here's like you know, what we did as a super refresh on the website of someone or whatever, you know, is the maybe either added service or just something new or some excuse to come back to them.
Yeah. So actually one thing I should have mentioned probably at the beginning is we work on a subscription basis. So our clients work with us on a monthly retainer. And in fact, we have very, very low churn. So typically we sign up with a client or a client signs up with us because it's such a specific solution for their needs. They end up sticking with us typically long term. So we don't really have much opportunity to go and then sell, you know, past clients. We don't have a lot of past clients. Most of our past clients are still current clients, but you know, the idea of maybe layering on different service offerings without getting away from what we're trying to create is definitely opportunities for us in the future. It's something that we have to be very, very careful with because we built our entire business. You know, our core philosophy is we're very, very simple. We're very specific. This is exactly what we do. So we don't want to muddy those waters with those services, but we have such strong relationships with our clients and there's so much trust there that if we did then say, oh, by the way, now we're going to do SEO, now we're going to do video.
Well, I don't think you even need to provide like such a big, you know, service that is completely different. One of the biggest engine for really good agency is referrals.
Yeah.
So that may be also something that, you know, I don't know how far you are with referrals, but that could be something to look into including into your process.
Yes. So can I tell you about our new referral program that we're
doing? Well, for sure. Go for it.
With the help of, using Vidyard, I'm in the process now. So we're rolling out this referral program. Any one of our marketing managers, if they refer someone to us that signs on to a paid client, they get $500 cash directly to them. The way we're implementing that is actually recording videos for each of our existing clients that they can then send to people to refer. So it's basically, it goes back to that, you know, it's a specific video, you know, hey, John from XYZ company thought you'd be a great fit. Here's a little bit about us, you know, blah, blah, pain sales pitch. Let us know what we can create for you for free.
Hey, I think that's awesome.
So that's our referral program that we're rolling out. So we tried in the past doing referrals and it's a different thing. It takes, you know, a lot of explanation. It's kind of a delicate sales process. So by having a video that we can give to clients to then give to people to distribute that very, very easily, we think that's finally going to help us get a referral program that works.
A lot of gems out here. Yeah,
that's right. And one last thing I would say about referral is do time referrals well or do test different timing. Like it's been proven that within the first 2 weeks of engagement, this is when the chances of referral are much higher than it is, you know, after the engagement, 90 days down the line or stuff like that. So do play with that timeline as well, because it could have like a tremendous impact on your actual results.
Yeah, that makes sense.
So I have one more note about inbound, and I'm not going to pretend I'm the inbound expert because I'm not. But I will tell you that in a very serious way, I think inbound is not for everyone. And if you happen to be playing in a smaller space where you need to be surgical with your targeting, if you end up turning down. So imagine you had, you know, 10,000 visitors a month instantly, you know, for the amount of work that it would take to create that traffic, how many of them would actually become good qualified customers for you? And for some businesses, it's a no-brainer. Go inbound, long-term strategy, it pays off. But if you find yourself in a position where outbound is really profitable and you're able to reach the right kind of people and you have a really strict set of parameters for who you do business with and who you don't, inbound can be a distraction. So I, you know, they say do more of what works. And I just say that as a cautionary note, because it's possible that you may revert back to outbound that was working so well, even though inbound could work. I'm not sure if it's even worth going there.
Well, Jack, just to add on this one, I mean, the inbound, you don't get to decide who come and, you know, book you or try to take some of your time. With outbound, you get to decide. So that's big difference. Like you're going to have to filter noise one way or another in inbound.
Yeah. And so what I think might work for us, and again, everything's kind of up in the air. We played as we go along. Do inbound, create content, but as a means to supplement our outbound efforts. You know, as I mentioned.
Very good.
Yeah. Awesome.
To have content to send to people for them to find stuff on the website when they go to the website. So it's not, we're not doing inbound, we're not creating content with the interest of like improving our search rankings and having people land on our website. It's to have content there to bolster these other outbound efforts. So I think that's going to be, once we have time to focus in on content, we do a little bit, that's going to be kind of the next step, I think.
Well said. Yeah. Sort of use it to show your worth. And we had a brilliant branding consultant, Dragos, over at crop.studio, and he was a big proponent of using content to help you close. He basically said, if you don't have content on your site, how do you expect marketers or salespeople or whoever you're trying to pitch to, if it's B2B, how do you expect them to trust you with their precious marketing dollars, right? So using content to sort of back up why you should work together makes a lot of sense from the outbound perspective. Trevor, any other questions to rapid fire before we close it out for today?
No, I can't think of anything. I think it was definitely helpful. I appreciate you guys taking some time to address kind of what we're trying to accomplish here. And we'll probably get an endless parade of emails for me to follow up afterwards. Hey, what do you guys think about this? What do you think about this?
Yeah.
I hope you don't mind me pestering you with that. But
no, it's great.
For sure.
It's great. And I'm sure our listeners appreciated it too. So good questions, man. All right, books.
Yeah, exactly. The books. What books or resources in general do you actually go for?
Yeah, podcasts, whatever.
Yeah, so I'm a big audiobook guy. I encourage everybody to get into audiobooks, get the Audible app, just start incorporating it into your daily life. You'd be amazed at how many books you can actually get through and read. Now, talking to an audience of outbound marketers, obviously anything sales copywriting related. So I would start with Building a Brand Story by Donald Miller. Anything by Donald Miller is an absolute must. He just came out with a new book called Marketing Made Simple. If anybody's listening to this that doesn't know who Donald Miller is, immediately rush to go pick up some of his stuff. His core message in everything that he does is just clarity. Confusion is the enemy. Clarity it will always win in any scenario in sales. And in fact, I like him because I myself, and actually, Jack, I'm not sure what your opinion is of this. I myself believe that copy can never be too long. It can only be poorly timed and too boring. And so he. And his work is actually the epitome of that because his books, there's no disguise about this, his books are essentially pieces of copy that he uses to sell his seminars. And I read his books over and over again every single year. And I will take one of his seminars one of these days because, it's so engaging. It's so well done. So,
but you didn't yet. You didn't take any of his seminar yet.
No, not yet. But
okay, so it's a very long-term view, right?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. anything by Donald Miller, a couple of very tactile books. So On Writing Well, To the Point. Point is a thesaurus that I always have right next to me. People on the cast can't see that. Basically, the thesaurus, you go through, you find a phrase that you feel just feels a little bulky and wordy, and they'll give you a kind of a condensed, shorter version to use. Words That Work is another good one. There was another one. Bear with me here. Actually, I'm not going to be able to find it. I just gave it to Ebony, who we just hired. Anything that's going to help you clarify your message, use more concise language. Those are very, very important. The Ultimate Sales Machine, and then anything by Dan Kennedy. Yeah. Dan Kennedy. But
At Holmes.
Absolute must. Pick up anything by Donald Miller. And in fact, he's got a really cool website called the 5-Minute Marketing Makeover. And it's kind of an introduction to his content and his style. It's 3 5-minute long videos, and it's just a must read for everybody. Start picking up some of his stuff right away.
Cool. I'm going to
Trevor, thank you.
Drop one actually for if you're so much into those marketing sales letter kind of thing. There's one called the 16 Words Sales Letter. Did you read this one?
No, I didn't, because they don't have an audio version.
That's right. I had to buy it on Kindle. That's exactly right.
It's in my wish list in Kindle that when I actually have some time to sit down and do actual reading,
it's
at
good.
The top of the list.
It's
Is it
good.
Worth it?
It's actually pretty good. And I actually like that I got it paper, because now I can, I can actually just scribble on it and keep some notes. Well, paper, like Kindle, doing some notes.
The 16-word sales letter?
Yeah, it's pretty good. It's unfortunately cool. Expensive. They make it on purpose, but it's all about what Trevor was saying, make it super clear, get one message, only one message, and then just go with it. And then answer 10 different questions based on that message. It's pretty good.
Okay, so Trevor, since we're wrapping up here, you had mentioned that you have a nice graphic. Maybe it's an infographic for marketers. I think listeners may want to check it out. Can you give us a link where we can find that?
Sorry, which one are you referring to?
You had mentioned that you put together marketing stuff. It's guide to marketing.
Yeah, so it's the ultimate encyclopedia of marketing stuff. So you guys can see that. We actually have physical copies too that we made.
Nice.
So if anybody goes to our website, there's going to be a pop-up right on there. And what this is... Cool. is it's a collection of our past projects. It's in a way a portfolio, but it's also a resource that we give to people because our solution is so simple and easy to get stuff done that in many cases, the only thing holding back marketers or businesses is just they don't have enough ideas or enough stuff or content to work on. So this is literally a catalog of stuff they can go through and say, oh, my business needs this, my business needs that.
Right.
That's cool. It's like IKEA for marketers.
We created that as also, you know, an answer to one of the big objections that we got from a lot of clients is like, this sounds great. This on-demand model sounds great, but we just don't have that much stuff to work on. And so our answer to that was, hey, grab a copy of this. I promise you, there's plenty of stuff you can work on, especially it's only going to take you a couple minutes each week with graphic design on demand.
Love it.
Brilliant. Yeah. So check it out. If you're a marketer, I'm not promising that Trevor's design company can take you. But certainly a good resource for marketers looking for more inspiration. And Trevor, you're certainly among one of the sharpest marketers we've had on the show here. And it was been a pleasure chatting marketing and growth with you.
Yeah, thanks so much, guys. It's a pleasure. Pleasure being here. Appreciate it. Yeah.
Thanks for coming to the show.
Hey, cold emailer.
Yeah, you.
If you got some value from this episode, give us a high five by sharing a 2-sentence review on iTunes.
Or Stitcher, or TuneIn, that works too.
It's a quick way to help other growth-minded folks like us find this podcast.
So they can send awesome emails.
And make everyone's inbox a better place. Thanks.